times Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Ghost. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Behold the handmaid of the Lord. Be it done unto me according to thy word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Let us pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, thy grace into our hearts, that as we have known the incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the message of an angel, so by his cross and passion may we come to know the glory of his resurrection, through the same Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. In tuoi portatari Dei ed Angeli edifica Juventutum Verum. Iurica medesa discende casa mente gente non santa, ma nomine nene codolo sorone. Quae tu est Deus futidurum, cora de tulisi, quali fisit in cielo, un officium enimicus. Em te lucem tu in veritate, in tu unissime, de luce non te luce, non ti mortum sanctum tuo, mente tabanato la tua. Et in tuoi portatari Dei ed Angeli edifica Juventutum Verum. Convite cuti vincitere, Deus, Deus, meus, quaecisit anima mea, quarque tu vas me. Sper in Deo, quorum et vo confidendo ibi, sanctari vultus me, et Deus meus. Gloria, Patri, Filio, et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Introi adoratari Dei, et Angeli edifica Juventutum meum, auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terra. Confiti, o Deo impotente, Beata Maria, semper vicere, beata et arcangelo, Confitio Deo Omnipotenti, Beate Maria Sempre Vigini, Beate Michaele Arcangelo, Beate Ioanni Battista, Sanctis Apostoli Spectro et Paolo, Omnibus Sanctis et Fidi Padre, Quia peccavi nimis cogitatione verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Et eo prego Beata Maria Sempre Vigini, Beate Michaele Arcangelo, Beate Ioanni Battista, Sanctus Apostolus Petrum et Paulum, Omnes Sanctos et Dei Pate, orare pro me, ad Domine Deo nostrum. Miseriatum vestri unipotens Deus, et mis peccatis vestris producat vos in vitam aeternam. Amen. Ad urgentiam sucionem, progressionem, peccatorum nos orum, te vivat nobis, et dimutens et misericus dormus.
Amen.
Deus conversus vivificabis nos,
et vestur et habitur in te,
mas sede nobis Domine misericordiam tuam,
et salutare tuam de nobis,
Domine exaudilatione meam, et clamo meus a te venia, Dominus obiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
ordem. Confessio pulchritudem in conspectu eius, sanctitas et magnificentia in sanctificatione eius. Cantate Domino canticum novum, cantate Domino omnis terra. Gloria Patri Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Confessio pulchritudem in conspectu eius, sanctitas et magnificentia in sanctificatione eius. Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Christe eleison,
Christe eleison,
Christe eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie eleison,
Kyrie eleison. Gloria in excelsis Deo, et in terra pax hominibus boni voluntatis, laudamus te, benedicimus te, adoramus te, glorificamus te, gratis agimus tibi propter magnam gloriam tuam, Domine Deus Rex Celestis, Deus Pater Omnipotens, Domine Filii Unigenite, Iesu Christe, Domine Deus Agnus Dei, Filius Patris, qui tollis peccata mundi miserere nobis, qui tollis peccata mundi suscipe deprecatione nostra, qui sedes et extra Patris miserere nobis, Oniam tu solus sanctus, tu solus dominus, tu solus altissimus, Iesu Christe, cum sanctus spiritu in gloria Dei Patris. Amen. Pax vobis.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Ardebus. Da nobis caesmus omnipotens Deus, vitiorum nostrorum flammas extinguere, quae beato Laurentio sui linguisti commentorum suorum incendia superare. Per Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, qui tegum vivit et regnat ad unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Orlebus. Sanctorum martyrum tuorum, tibotsi et susane nos Dominum fobiam, continuato presidia, quae non destinis propitius in tueri, vos taribus auxilius conceseris adiugavi. Alcuntis nos caesmus Domine mentis et copulis defendi periculis, et in decedente beati gloriosse sempre Virgine de Genetice Maria, cum beatu Iosif, beatis apostis tuis Petrus, Paulus, quae beatis putumane tui fidi Dominibus sanctis, salutem nobis tribu e vineus et pacem, ut istruxis et fisestasibus et gloribus universis, Iglesia tua securite mi servi et evitate. Perigundum Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, Filium Tuum, qui tegum vivit et regnat in unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Lex epistolae beati Pauli apostoli ad Corinthios. Frates, qui pace semina pace admettet, et qui semina in benedictionibus, de benedictionibus admettet. Unis quisque praut distinavit in corde suo, non ex distitia, aut ex necessitate, il ardem enim datorem diligit Deus. Potens est autem Deus omnem gratiam abundari facere in vobis, ut in omnibus sendo omnem sufficientiam habentes, abundetes in omne o corpus bonum, sicut scriptum est. Dispersit dedit pauperibus, justitia eius manit in saeculum saeculi. Qui autem administrat semen seminansi, et panem et manducandum restabit, et multiplicabit semen vestrum, et obgebat incrementa frugum justitiae vestre.
Deo gratias.
Probasti Domine cor meum et visitasti nocte, inem examinasti et non est inventeri mei iniquitas. Alleluia, alleluia, levita Laurentius bonum opus operatus est, qui per signum crucis cecos illuminavit. Alleluia. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
sequentia sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem.
Gloria a tibi, Domine.
In illo tempore dicit Iesus discipulis suis, Amen, amen, dico vobis, nisi granum frumenti cadens in terra, mortuum fuerit, ipsum solum manet. Si autem mortuum fuerit, multum fructum effet. Qui amat animam suam perdit eam, et qui odit animam suam in hoc mundo, in vitam aeternam custodit eam. Si quis mihi ministrat me sequatur, et ubi sum ego, illic et minister meus erit. Si quis mihi ministravelit, honorificabit eum pater meus.
Laus tibi Christi.
This is the second feria of the octave of St. Lawrence, Deacon and Martyr, and the commemoration of Saints Tiburcius and Susanna, martyrs The epistle is taken from the second letter of St. Paul the Apostle to the Corinthians. Brethren, he who sows sparingly will reap sparingly. He who sows freely will reap freely too. Each of you should carry out the purpose he has formed in his heart, not with any painful effort. It is the cheerful giver God loves. God has the power to supply you abundantly with every kind of blessing, so that, with all your needs well supplied at all times, you may have something to spare for every work of mercy. So we read, he has spent largely and given to the poor. His charity lives on forever. He who puts grain into the sower's hand and gives us food to eat will supply you with seed and multiply it and enrich the harvest of your charity. And the Holy Gospel is a continuation of that according to St. John. At this time, Jesus said to his disciples, believe me when I tell you this, a grain of wheat must fall into the ground and die, or else it remains nothing more than a grain of wheat. But if it dies, then it yields rich fruit. He who loves his life will lose it. He who is an enemy to his own life in this world will keep it, so as to live eternally. If anyone is to be my servant, he must follow my way. So shall my servant too be where I am. If anyone serves me, my Father will do him honour. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. In nomine Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. Carissimi, beloved in Christ, welcome to this broadcast Mass. On this, as we said, the Feria, the second day in the octave of St. Lawrence, Deacon and Martyr. And today we commemorate two, Saints Tiburcius and Susanna. Both martyred during the persecution of the church in the reign of Diocletian. This was the persecution that followed that of Valerian, during which St. Lawrence, whom we commemorated yesterday, was martyred with Pope Sixtus II and the other deacons of Rome. Tiburcius was beheaded, and so too was Susanna. Both, of course, for refusing to denounce and renounce their faith and confession in Jesus Christ. Susanna had been, the daughter of a priest, and they were of noble Roman stock, so that Diocletian had desired Susanna to marry Maximus, his nephew. She refused because she had consecrated herself to Christ, and because, of course, Maximus himself was not a Christian. She managed also to convert her uncles, whom Diocletian sent to persuade her otherwise, so that indeed both her uncles, herself and her father were all martyred for the faith. Her uncles were burnt to death, and she and her father were beheaded. It seems perhaps often a little bit alien to us when we hear of the method of martyrdom that martyrs in times past endured. And yet, of course, there is nothing new under the sun. And although it is not reported by our media day after day, nonetheless, on a daily basis, there are Christians, brothers and sisters, in this time, in this life, in this world of ours, who are experiencing similar fates to those that we hear about of the historic martyrs. There are contemporary Christian martyrs who too are being burnt to death, or being beheaded, or having their throats cut, or being crucified, being tortured and tormented, being raped and pillaged. And as we've reflected before, something in the region of 150,000 per year since the turn of the millennium. Which I think, if I remember rightly, makes it almost 50 a day. No, 50 an hour. It seems quite incredible to us. So shielded and protected are we by our media, so that we don't hear. We don't hear about this heroic witness going on in other places of the world. Instead, all we hear about from our media here in the West is how evil and awful the Christian Church is. All we ever hear about the Christian Church in our Western media is the bad news. Despite all the very good work that Christians are doing, and that if they weren't doing, our societies indeed would be extremely impoverished. If it weren't for Christians feeding and sheltering the homeless, if it weren't for Christians seeking out and looking after the poor, we would realise quite how corrupt and broken is our welfare state. Just in this city of Brighton and Hove alone, not very big as cities go, population-wise, roughly between 250 to 300,000 souls, yet about 30,000 households, families, poor families, are supported by Christians in this city alone. Roughly 30,000 households a month. But you won't hear about that in the news, and you won't hear about that even in our local newspapers. You won't hear about the work that the churches in this city do. It's not often at all we hear about, in winter, the shelter, the only shelter that runs for 3 months of the winter in this city is hosted and provided by churches. You might hear now and again about the emergency night shelter, which only operates in severe weather conditions. So on an ad hoc basis. You might hear about that, but you very rarely, if ever, hear about the seven churches that take it in turns every night of the week to host the homeless in their church halls or church buildings, providing an evening meal and breakfast and showering facilities. A survey commissioned almost 10 years ago now of all the Christian churches in the city revealed surprising information statistically about how much the churches here do for others. That's where that figure of about 30,000 families a month came from, almost 10 years ago. So you can imagine that that number will be increased, particularly now as things have worsened economically. And that survey came about from a meeting between Churches Together and the leader of the council, the then leader of the council, sorry, not the leader, the CEO, the chief executive officer, who came to us because at that time, of course, David Cameron was prime minister and everyone was talking about big society, which essentially meant that the government was withdrawing social funding and was basically seeking to encourage more charities to do more to make up the shortfall in the provision of services, especially social and welfare. But of course, none of that was ever reported in the press. None of that was ever reported in the media. And if one was to collate all the statistical information of what the churches do across this country, one would be similarly amazed at how much the welfare fabric of our society is propped up by those bad Christians, by those killjoy Christians, by those judgmental Christians. People sometimes say to me, Father, where is the persecution of the church here in the West? We have freedom of religion. We have freedom of expression, freedom of thought. And to all of which I ask, do we? Do we have freedom of conscience, freedom of thought? Are we permitted? Are we allowed to think the way we want to think about certain things? Do we have freedom of expression, freedom of speech? Are we really allowed to express, to say aloud what we think? Do we really have freedom of religion? I've always found it quite interesting, quite bizarre, that one can be a member of a minority faith in Great Britain and have one's employers jump through hoops to try and accommodate your religious practice and observance. But if you're a Christian in this country, and for example, you wanted Maundy Thursday and Good Friday off for religious observance, you wouldn't get it. If you wanted to leave work to hear Mass on a feast day, on a holy day of obligation, you wouldn't get it. You wouldn't get the permission, even though you might only be gone an hour. Of course, in all these things, they would expect you to use your annual leave, perhaps you're on flexi time. You would have to rearrange things to suit, possibly. But then if somebody else is off sick on the day, somebody else doesn't turn up for work, and they need a minimum number of staff, then you won't be given permission to go, even for an hour. All this despite the fact that this is historically a Christian country. Of course, in times past, bank holidays were given to enable Christians to observe the greater feasts. Maundy Thursday used to be one such day, Good Friday too. But as our society becomes increasingly secularized and materially driven, under pressure from employers and lobbyists, our bank holidays are being whittled away. And because of the broad apostasy and apathy of Christians in the past, no voices, no fuss has been made to defend the right to freedom of religion for Christians in this country. In many and various ways, the Church in the West is enduring persecution. It's just that most Christians are either apostate, so they are ignorant that there is even a problem, or they are so apathetic that they don't do anything about it. The sad truth, then, of the matter is about the situation of the Church in the West. That it pales in comparison to the Church elsewhere and to the Church of times past. Christians in the West may not be dragged physically before a pagan idol and pressured, coerced with violence to pay homage or burn incense. But we're all too willing and ready and prepared to embrace the concepts of mammon, that feed our selfishness and our greed. All too ready to ignore tradition and scripture, to embrace secularized concepts and ideologies about the nature of society, about the nature of community, about the nature even of the family. Are we not then guilty of denouncing Christ, of renouncing Christ? If, my brothers and sisters, if we truly believe in the gospel, if we truly believe in Jesus Christ, if we truly believe in God and the prospect of heaven, or indeed hell, at the prospect of being with God knowingly for eternity, or being without him, should we not be prepared to speak up, should we not be as vocal as others are to defend our freedoms? Should we not be prepared to face whatever onslaught may come for the sake of Christ? for otherwise it means nothing to remember and to commemorate the heroic lives of martyrs past and present. We might as well just shut up shop. Unless the remembrance, unless the commemoration of martyrs past and present changes and influences our own attitudes and approach . Remember that we are here now because of the witness and the testimony of the martyrs of times past. And if we are to stand any chance of being here until the Lord comes again, we need ourselves to be prepared to make known the heroic witness of contemporary martyrs, and be ourselves prepared to face whatever may come for speaking the truth about Jesus Christ and about his church, his body. We should be more vocal in the West about the suffering of our brothers and sisters in the East. We should be more vocal in the West to defend our freedom of thought, our freedom of expression, our freedom of religion. We should be doing much more people to know the good that we do. To counter the negativity and discouragement that comes from ultimately only one source. And it is he, not the state, not society, not our neighbours, who can only harm us physically. It is not them that we should fear. And it is not them that we are or should be prepared to battle with. But he of whom our Lord said has the power to destroy our soul. We should take anything from the commemoration of the saints this week. It's to be vigilant, to be aware of the influence of evil, and be stoic and steadfast in rejecting it and in fighting it. By doing so with sacrificial loving. Doing so by being true to God's law of love. Doing so by being true to God in the living of our lives. Putting our trust in him, finding our strength in him, and allowing him to use us to make his will and purpose known, so that as many as possible may be saved and brought to the knowledge of their redemption and ours in him, who who is God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Oremus. Confessio et pugit rudum in conspetu eius sanctitas et magnificentia in sanctificatione eius. Orate, fratres, ut mem vestum sacrificium acceptabile fiat ab Deo Patri nomine potente. Suscipia Dominus sacrificium de manibus nostris, et ad gloria nomis sui, et facilitatum quo nostram totiusque ecclesiae sui sanctae. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo.
Sos in corda,
habemus ad Dominum.
Gratias ad amus Domino Deo nostro,
dignum et justum est.
Vere dignum et justum est ecome salutare in nostri vi sempre dubique, gratias agere Domine, sancte Pater omnipotens et aeterne Deus. Per Christum Dominum nostrum, pecuem maestatem tuum laudant angeli adorando omenationes, tremunt potestates, celi celorunque virtutes et beati seraphim, socius protectione concedebant, cum quibus in nostris voces ut emittimus bestia precamur, supplici confessione dicentes.
Sanctus, 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 Dominus Deus Sanctus, pleni sunt celi et terra gloria tua. Hosanna in excelsis.
Benedictus. Nobis quoque peccatoribus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum. preceti salutaribus moniti divinis institutioni formati, audemus dicere. Pater noster, qui es in cieli, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum de nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentatione.
Sed libera nos a male.
Sicula siculorum.
Amen.
Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace. Domine non sunt dignus. Domine non sunt dignus. Domine non sunt dignus. Ecce Agnus Dei, ecce qui tollit peccato mundi.
Domine non sunt dignus, udite sed tecta me, sed tanto de verbo, et sed habitur animo me.
Domine non sunt dignus, udite sed tecta me, sed tanto de verbo, et sed habitur animo me. Domine non sunt dignus, udite sed tecta me, sed tanto de verbo, et sed habitur anima mea. Brothers and sisters watching Mass online and unable therefore to receive the Blessed Sacrament, we invite you now to make an act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that thou art present in the Blessed Sacrament. I love thee above all things, and I desire thee in my soul. Since I cannot now receive thee sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. As though thou wert already there, I embrace thee, and unite myself wholly to thee. Permit not that I should ever be separated from thee. Amen. ministeras me sequatur, et ubi ego sum inicet minister meus et. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
oremus.
Sacrum uneris assiasi supplices te Domine deprecamur, utque debite servitutis celebramus officio, intercedente beatu Laurentiu martire tuo, salvationis tue essentiamus auguntum. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum finum tuum, qui tenum vivit et regnat in aeternitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Ordemus. Sumsimus Domine pignus redemptionis aeternae, quantit nobis caesimus interferentibus sanctis matilibus tuis, vitae presentis auxilium pariter et future. Unde remunia nos caesimus Domine divini sacramenti mulus oblatum, et intercedente beate Virgine et Genetrice Maria, cum beato Iosef, beatis apostis tuis Petrus, Paulus, quae beatis, cum mani tui fili et omnibus sanctis, acuntis nos redet professasissibus ex beatos, et professasissibus ex benditas. Perigundum Dominum nostrum, Iesum Christum, finium tuum, qui tecum vivit et regnat in aeternitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Amen. Dominus vobiscum,
et cum spiritu tuo,
ite missa est,
Deo
gratias. Sit nomen Domini benedictum, ex omnum codusque in saecula auditorium nostrum in nomine Domini, qui feci caelum et terram, benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus. Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Dominus vobiscum,
et cum Spiritu tuo,
initium Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem,
gloria tibi Domine.
In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat ab Deum, et Deus erat verbum, hoc erat in principio ab Deum. Omnium ipsum factum sunt, ipsum factum est, ipsum factum est. In ipso vita erat lus habitum, et lus in terribus, lucere terribus, et non comprehenderum. Quae tomo missus del cui nomen erat Ioannes, sic veritum testimoni nunc testimoni bibere, tu lumen et omnes crebunt primum. Non erat in lux, sic ut testimoni bibere, tu lumen, erat lux vera, quae luminat omnem habitem reentem in mundum. In mundum erat, in mundus principum factus est, in mundus nehum non conlogi. In proprio veritis omnem ceperum, in corpo latem ceperum Deum Deus, vere statum fios, tiem fieri, is preferent in nomine eius, qui non est sanguinibus, nec voluntati canis, nec voluntati viris, et dermati sunt. Et verbum carnum factum est, et habitavit in nobis et minimus gloria meus, gloria quas unigenite a Patri per gratia veritatis.
Deo gratias.
Amen. Grace and always be thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary,
Mother of God,
pray
for us sinners now and the hour of our death. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee, blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of mercy,
hail our life, our sweetness, and our hope.
To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve.
To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this vale of tears.
Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. O
God, who art our refuge and our strength, look down in mercy on thy people who cry to thee, and by the intercession of the glorious and blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, St. Joseph, a spouse of thy blessed apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all thy saints. In mercy and goodness hear our prayers for the conversion of sinners and for the liberty and exaltation of our Holy Mother, the Church. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Holy Michael, Archangel,
defend us in the day of battle. Be our safeguard against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust down to hell Satan and all wicked spirits who wander through the world for the ruin of souls. Amen.
Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God, have mercy upon me, a sinner. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of God,
have mercy upon me, a sinner.
May St. Lawrence, Deacon and Martyr,
pray for us.
May Saints Tiberius and Susanna, Martyrs,
pray for us.
May Saints Catherine and Wilfrid,
pray for us.
May St. Luwina,
pray for us.
May St. Richard,
pray for us.
May Our Lady of Walsing, all the angels and saints,
pray for us.